Yep. No, just for like about 20 seconds. Yeah, it's on 20 seconds now. Okay. Yep. Yeah, it's on about 20 something seconds. Okay.
First and foremost, I'm going to start off by giving all praise, glory, and honor to Yahweh Shem, Yahweh Shai, Ba Shem, Rakakadash.
Double honor to the elders and apostles of great millstone who taught us this truth and which rule well. And salutations to the hopeful elect brothers. After pushing said truth across the four corners of the globe, risking your freedoms and your lives to do so, you know, which is coming out, bringing this truth. Hoping that the elect will wake up soon, and it's coming very soon, but along with comes with that is the destruction of the wicked, man. You know? In which a lot of people are gonna fall in that light. Because everybody hears about that old scripture that's in Matthew's 7th chapter, you know, that broad is the way that leadeth unto destruction, and straight is the way that leadeth unto life. You know, roughly paraphrasing, somebody wanna get that. But that's an actual saying, man, you know? Because these people have a herd mentality. Now, if you follow that herd, well, the herd is going to go into destruction, man. Because they're like a beast. So what? But yeah, that beast-like mentality is going to lead you to be destroyed like a beast, man. Shot down like a dog in the street. But that's what's about to come, man. All right? You follow these filthy ways the Lord told us to not follow. Well, what's going to be... What's going to be reaped of that is a life of filth, and filth is going to get clean. Somebody want to get that Isaiah 2, where the Lord said he's going to third wound purge the floor. He's going to come and clean house, man. He's going to get the animals and the animal shit out the fucking house, because it's been too long, man. Even the inhabitants are suffering under the hands of the wicked, man, starting with the elites on down to even you peon niggas, man. Because the thing about a wicked motherfucker is that they're really oppressed. They're even oppressive unto themselves and their inheritance, man, and their generation. But the Lord has had enough, man. So he's about to come save man from himself. Because by the hands of man, is this place going to be destroyed, man? Well, really, it's going to be by the hands of the Most High, but he's going to use your one group of devils, who are another group of Edomites, to be destroyed by another group of devils, who are another group of Edomites. The heathen's going to destroy the heathen. You wanted this place so bad, well, look what you did with it, man. And now the Lord is going to come and take it from you.
2nd Esdras 9:13. And therefore... 2nd Esdras 9:13. And therefore be thou not curious how the ungodly shall be punished and when, but inquire how the righteous shall be saved, whose the world is, and for whom the world is created.
Right. Because the thing is, the Lord said that he blesses the habitation of the just, meaning that the righteous is going to inherit the earth forever, man. Is it not written that the meek shall inhabit the earth? So like that, inhabit, well, they're going to inhabit it, but they're going to inherit it, man. We're going to inherit the earth, man. So we be those men. So with that being said, the lot of those that are not going to inherit the earth are manslayers, you know, idolaters, abusers of themselves with mankind, all right? Whoremongers and whores too. You don't get it, hey man, none of you get an excuse to do wickedly, man. The Lord's going to come back and he's going to purge this place of that. He's going to cleanse this place of that, man. Because it's a proud spirit, it's a spirit he doesn't want in the earth. It's a spirit that thinks it's smart and it's dumb as hell. Like, who wants to deal with a dumb, smart nigga, man?
Verse 14, 2nd Esdras 9:14. Then answered I and said, I have said before, and now do speak, and will speak it also hereafter, that there be many more of them which perish than of them which shall be saved.
That's right, man. Going back to the that, man. No. The inhabitants didn't want to listen. Listen to him on mercifully, man. Oh, he's going to burn her this time. Is that mercy? Yes, man. Because everybody had that chance. Ultimately, it was fucking elect. But at least the heathen could have stopped fucking doing what the hell they was doing unto us, man. As a people. Us the nation of Israel. But no, hey, man, even our own people don't want to have mercy on us, man. So the Lord is justified doing everything he's about to do, man. But hey, man, these men out here, they weren't, hey, man, by our own deeds, we weren't perfect. We turn from our deeds, listen unto the scriptures, man. Okay. So Lord, what are we holding on to the scriptures? Of them that is a Jew, and we get the hell up out of here, man.
Okay. 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 20. When some time were disobedient, when once the Lord suffered, or the Most High, waited the days of Noah, while the ark was prepared, wherein few, that is, eight souls were saved by water.
It said few souls were saved, man, by the destruction of water. By the destruction of water to this earth, you know, it was only about eight souls saved, man. One being the father of Noah,
the camera.
His wife, his sons, and their wives, man. That was the mercy that the Lord had on his creation, because he could just do it. And his whole plan was to make it back to righteousness, man. Well, really, you know, it's to bring back this up so they can, you know, bring back our line and then bring about a place called America to destroy it and bring everlasting righteousness, man. And this is going to be the place that is a memorial of not to do wicked. Because it was that tree. It was the ending of that wicked tree, man. It's the end of that wicked seed from on that. And you people don't want to hear it, so you're going to be caught up in it. It's not going to be no Lord in that day, no God, please save me, save my kids, save my family, save my mama. Lord's not about to have mercy on you, man. But it says, hey, man, with that anger against the river, y'all just don't fucking know that the Lord's about to burn your ass up. Which is, hey, what do they say one of the most tormented ways to die? And it's mentioned in the scriptures multiple times, man. The Lord coming with fire and thousands of his saints, man. With fire! Because he got a clean house, man.
He said it's coming with fire. Can I grab this right quick?
Go ahead.
This is Malachi 4:1. For behold, the day comes that shall burn as an oven, and all the proud.
All the proud!
Yea, and all that do wickedly.
All that do wickedly. So it's not just that you know you're a wicked motherfucker, but you're proud. Because you know, hey, you could be ignorant to doing wicked. But when you tell a nigga like, hey man, you know you shouldn't be smoking. Nah, nigga, the fuck out of my face, David.
I don't
see nothing. My bad. I thought you were about to say something. My bad. But yeah, hey, a nigga's ready to brawl with you, man. That's why it says cast not your pearl before a swine. Hey, this troop is really only for the men that the Lord has set up. We're only fishing for the elect. We ain't trying to go out there and correct every last Israelite in the world, man. We ain't trying to be super duper Israelite. We understand that this is on the Lord's time. Meaning we can't go to another nation and do it. It's not for them. And we can't force it, man. We can't go out there and arms, man. This is about the spirit of the Lord coming out and doing it how he said to do it, man. Walking as he did, man. Not being ultimate tough guy, super duper Israelite. Talking about you tote sticks and things like that, man. Our warfare is not carnal. We understand that the Lord's about to bring this down in his time, and you see it happening. But hey, the preaching of this is foolishness unto the unwise, man.
I got a precept for you to that point. And it's Romans 13:1. That every soul be subject to the higher powers, but there is no power but of the Most High. The powers that be are ordained of the Most High. So where was therefore resisting the powers, the ordinance of the Most High? They that resist shall receive themselves damnation. Alright, so the Lord said Esau what? Alright, hey, it was an act. I was talking about going against the disciples. But he said, unless you have them, you should fight against the Most High. No, that's what we're doing. You can't take Esau. He says, the Lord saw Pierce the fight done. The Lord got to take this devil down. You come against Esau with your own power. Niggas make. Not even niggas. They are niggas, you know. But it's. Told the brothers that know they Israelites rapping about how they got stuck. The brother said they got sticks and everything. Like, why they gotta do anything, man? That's not gonna save you. King David, the mightiest warrior ever in Israel outside of Yahushua, alright? He said he don't trust in the sword. When he made songs, he made sure he said, I don't boast in my gun. He's like, fuck a sword, fuck a gun. You know, because the guns are my very sword. Alright? You got these people that's supposed to be into the scriptures rapping about their vacuum sticks and tools and glorifying what they did and they passed and all. Come on, man. For rulers are not a terror, back in Romans 13:3. For rulers are not a terror to good works, but to the evil. Wilt thou then not be afraid of the power? Do that which is good, and thou shalt have praise of the same. He is the minister of the Most High to be for good, but if thou do that which is evil, be afraid. We bear not the sword of fame. He is the minister of the Most High. I refuse to execute wrath upon that book evil. That goes to Isaiah the 10th chapter, man. Alright, the Lord called Assyria, this is my best Assyria. He called Assyria his sword. Hey, in Psalms, I believe it's Psalm 78. Man.
Real quick, this is Psalms 44:6. For I will not trust in my bow, neither shall my sword save me.
Nah, King David said my sword ain't gonna save me. He ain't boasting in it, man. And that's a real song right there. Alright? You gonna make music, and the truth, that's the music you make. You gonna rap it, you gonna sing and make music against Edom, man. But it's gotta be in the spirit. King David said, through the name of the Lord, I ran through a truth. Alright? His honor to have all his saints praising Yahweh. He wasn't called no Christ in the Psalms either, man. He said, praise Yahweh. Give him the name of them, man.
Psalm 17:13. Arise, O Yahweh, and disappoint him. Cast him down. Deliver my soul from the wicked, which is thy sword.
There you go. So the Lord's sword is the wicked. You're going to fight against the Lord. You're actually going to be fighting against the Lord's weapon, man. No, man. It says the saints protect the kingdom, but that's on the Lord's time.
Ezekiel 21:9. Son of man, prophesy and say, thus saith the Lord, a sword is sharpened, and also furnished. It is sharpened to make a sword slaughter. It is furnished that it may glitter. Should we make mercy? Should we then make mercy? It is content the rod of my son as every tree.
That's the Lord. Alright, the only way to escape this judgment is Yahweh Vashem Yahweh Shai. Alright, Yahweh Shai is our Savior, not ourselves. Now, yes, Obadiah mission saviors, but how do we do that? 1 Timothy, the 4th chapter. Take heed to the doctrine to thyself, for in doing it to save thyself, we may hear thee. Doing this work, it's how the Lord willing, we find favor. And like Paul said, I hope to win Yahweh Shai. So when Yahweh Shai delivers us, man, you know, which is still him, he gave us the truth. You know, Yahweh Bashmashach gave us the gift of faith. It was all still the Lord. Alright? We're not delivering ourselves by carnal means. At some point it will turn physical, but even then, you're gonna have spiritual powers, man. You can't take yourself down no other fucking way. You think so, you crazy, man. Alright, the Lord set up kings, man. Promotion coming from the Most High. You know, ain't nobody fighting against Esau, man. You know?
Says, but thou wilt say to the wicked people, they will bring down my looks. But thou wilt light my candle, and thou art my power, and the light of my heart.
Right, so that's what you want to. Alright, the Lord can take down the crowd. It's his day, it says, baby, the Lord's meant to be. Alright, that's the Heavenly Father. He gets the message. Alright? So, first step, I can't begin to look for him.
By thee, I have blood to the
sun. So then, what comes to spiritual power? That's the first chapter. Alright? Wait, rules will make it, and then power shall be given to you, man. So get this Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost in us, man. The Holy Ghost been activating in us. Depending on the faith in the womb, man. Alright? Being activated in us, while we're living with the blood, and we're going to get power.
By my power, by my leap over the world.
To all those that trust in him.
Right. The Lord is our shield, man. You ain't got to go to the temple to pull up your flesh. And then hard to deliver us. But when the Western Giants come, hey, we got to deal with it. You out there boasting and wearing a bulletproof vest to camp, man. That's crazy.
They show you got no faith.
No faith. Right. And Stephen was confident even in his death.
Because boasting you faith. You got certain guns that can still use a bulletproof vest, man. Certain bullets.
Hey, look. Dude, I was up to the stand. I didn't want to poke it, nigga.
Never, yeah.
That's true, man. You wear your vest. Shot, man. Hey, that was like, a lot of Drake actually get angry from being reckless, man.
Yep.
Niggas just reckless. A lot of times, niggas just scoring and doing random shit. So random motherfuckers, man, they don't shoot shit. But a nigga like Trent, they gonna get your ass, man. Yeah, you got no chance, and the thing about that is, once yourself, that Yes, you still wanted just to take America, right, to have a place in America, because that's the whole world stage. You're looking for world dominance here, man. We're not trying to get our fair shake in America or none of that. We're looking for world dominance, man. All right, a real new world order. All right? But he said, no, we will flip our horses. Therefore shall you flee. And we will ride upon the swift. Therefore stand pursuit you be swift. Whatever car to make protected to escape or do this, do that, the horse gonna make the enemy even better at it, man. Your thousand shall flee as a group of one. After a group of five shall you flee. So you'll be left as a beacon upon the top of the mountain and as an ensign on the hill. So hey, the Lord gonna allow you sort of get a hold of you because I'm gonna take things to your own hands, man. And she just be elected to us as an ensign. How would that be a sign? Because the Lord's going to cover us and bless us, man. And while we're going to be elected, he'll give us a power. And when Egypt gets destroyed, you can look and see the light in Goshen. All right, you can see the light where Israel was at. Israel had their cattle when Egypt got destroyed. When darkness was there, we had our light. When the firstborn was killed, we had our firstborn. Alright? Same thing now, man. And therefore, with the Lord wait, he may be gracious unto you. The Lord's gonna allow Esau to get you niggas out the way, man. And therefore, when he be exalted, he may have mercy upon you. For the Lord is a power of judgment. Blessed are all that wait for him.
This is book of 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 4. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through Yahweh, to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of Yahweh, and bringing into captivity every thought to be obedience of HaMashiach. We don't need weapons. Our weapons are the scriptures, man. Okay, just like how Esau be at his gun range and all that, we at our range, breaking down these scriptures, this is my gift. This gift was only for the Israelites, man. All right? No other nation whatsoever.
We ain't going to have to do some war.
We never wrestled with an angel, man. Jacob.
Good point. Jacob wrestled with an angel
with
his bare hands. And the angel told him to have power with the Most High and man.
You never went the same that you didn't get
him. You trust me, though. And King David gave the ultimate example. He told that tall, freaky, dippy Philistine, you come to me with sword and shield, but I come with you in the name of Yahweh. And he grabbed smooth stones, not sharp stones, these are round stones that can't even cut up just as big as it. But he washed it and sunk in his hand, man, to show the power of Yahweh.
It's not about man. It's by the way it's done, it's all parts of cardinality. You gotta use your lips. You gotta make a gimmick into it. This is all about the spirit, man. And the spirit. It's second Thessalonians, first chapter, man. It's like the other thing, man. This is all by the mouth of Yahweh Hashem Yahushua. He spoke by his holy prophets, man. You know, this has been going on since the world began, as Hebrew says, you know. And whenever there was a problem, if the Lord had a problem with, he would send a prophet, and he would send somebody to say, have to deal with certain problems, and he would be the one that would actually deal with the judgment, man. Even if he dealt with it through man's hand. Lord is telling us to send a different backup for you, man. And he's going to handle it all, man. He's going to handle the majority of it, man. And how about somebody outside? I always does the majority of the work, you know? The reason why there is no praise unto us, we were hoping you had mercy on us. We want to do this work. This is what he asked us to do. He is Jesus, man. This is how you get exempt. You do these things, and you teach them.
John 14:2. Like you said, the Lord does all the heavy lifting. So that my father's house are many mansions, if it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you. I said, the Lord's going to have us do certain things, move around the earth, and certain things you already been prepared for.
Far from the nigga, he's far from the house. Oh man, I don't want to do that.
I
That was a regular word. How much more the name before? Alright? say in Chicago, you like chicken. Everybody knows in Chicago, man. Somebody else, they like, you like really good. You gotta be from here.
That really happened, man. That's
where
I was playing the game.
Not Jehovah. It's not whatever bastard ass name is. Yeah, Speak henceforth to no man in this name. And they called them and
America not to speak at all, nor teach in his name of God.
That's what these words are down there, man. And they fear that name. Somebody read my ready for Malachi.
Of his lips. Building and whatnot.
Yeah, man,
yeah,
very good.
So, backing up what the elder said, we haven't found a way, man. You know, but now, like you said, the body of dry bone, man, we're getting that spiritual water on us now, man. And we coming back to our power, man. Right.
I got something. Okay, now I got something. So, in comparison, all right, we had the two-thirds just walk past right here, right? I want to go to Baruch 2. So, Baruch 2 and 29, and it reads, if ye will not hear my voice, truly this very great multitude shall be turned into a small among the nations, for I will scatter them. So we can scatter, right? And the elect rising up as a small number. It says, for I knew that they will not hear me, because it is a stiff neck to hear. Okay? But in the land of their captivities, they shall remember themselves.
They always grab we they cut up. We can trace our dollars to such space on the right. When they get cut off, these people right here.
So this wicked brother who was just standing here calling on that other name, he ain't remembering himself. But we're remembering ourselves. Listen to what the scripture says. Alright? It says in the land of their captivity, they shall remember themselves and shall know that I am the Lord their God. Okay, or Yahweh their power. For I will give them a heart and ears to hear. And they shall praise me in the land of their captivity and think upon my name. See, he don't know the name, right? And return from their stiff necks and from their wicked deeds. For they shall remember the way of their fathers, which sinned before the hour.
Well, they promised something, so the man must be the man.
So, in contrast, you know, when you see him and what he's talking about, and what we're talking about, it's two different things.
Hey, the skirt is full on this place. It's over. All the deeds of America.
America have been seen across the four corners of the globe. The inhabitants of America are just too stupid to realize their nation is the devil as well. Right? They will oppress certain citizens. Make them the ones on their side, but everybody in America is oppressed. Everybody's bitter. It's like, man, I was watching that show Breaking Bad. You know? He started actually being a devil to a lot of jets. When he watched, rewatched the show, he's been a devil in the jank. But he was actually a victim of his own Edomitehood, man. His own people had fucked him over with the healthcare, man. A lot of people get fucked over with the healthcare because the person that's in charge of all this is unrighteous as fuck. They sell you pharmaceuticals and really as a witchcraft, it fucks you up even more. They just want your ass downtown, drugged up, and sick, so you continue to get the money until you die, come back, get the money, and die, come back, your fucking children are debt slaves, even more, paying for mortgage, man. Pay for whatever type of debt that they can control you, man.
Everybody up there, come up there.
fixed interest rate, we saw six variable ones there, so it's great. All right, so I'm fixed on debt.
Yep, so yeah, we're working. Yeah, debt, no.
These are, you know, the loan rate over there, like you said, it's cool. But you don't have an answer to it.
Hey, that was the only black love. the rock. 27 to the record. The beer bomb was under the foul. I'm into this shit. I'm just saying.
Okay, I was in
all day.
No, 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 no.
grass, you dying out, man.
Their land, which I have given them, so I was like,
chapter 7, verse 18, that the saints should possess the kingdom, should take and possess the kingdom forever. Right? The saints are the kingdom.
He says, don't be the principle,
Perfect.
that last uppercut, man. That flawless fist.
Book of Lamentations, chapter 2, chapter 4, verse 21. Rejoice and be glad, O Lord of you, that dwells in the land of us. Blood also shall pass through unto thee, and thou shalt be drunken, and shall make thyself naked. That's the time we're in right now. They make themselves naked, because y'all just say the revelations, right? They being revealed, right? The punishment of thine iniquity is accomplished. We're coming down to that, man. We are going to solution to our punishment. This is the last captivity of you so-called Negro Latinos and Native Americans, man. All right, coming from under the power of these so-called white people, man. The punishment of thy iniquity is accomplished. O God of Zion, he will no more carry thee away into captivity. He's still in captivity, man. Okay? This is a prison house. You cannot leave this main land without a passport. Okay? Now you can't leave without the second sauce, man. You know? He will still in thy iniquity, O God of Edom. He will discover thy sins. Alright? So good, man. The Lord is good too. He let everybody put us in captivity, right? And he even put our woman that I want to put us in captivity in this captivity. So-called black woman is a lieutenant for Esau, he was a so-called white man, man. And everybody
talking
about
inequality. Hey man, our own women destroy us, man. I say Isaiah,
they have a
universal income.
Yeah, literally. You know what people, they're going to go down and they're going to go. But hey, the Lord
will punish
your ass exactly right there.
It's really to get the whole earth just
rocked up.
You get tricked real wicked. That's just wicked. Isaiah chapter 3, verse 11. Woe to the wicked, it should be ill with him, for the Lord is his, Isaiah chapter 3, verse 10. Say ye to the righteous that it should be well with him, for they should eat the fruit of their loins.
That's the value.
So when it happens at the end of the day, man, I did all this shit, yeah, and that was still mercy. So he, there's nothing on your plate. Hey, you deserve it. And a lot more, man, because the Lord is great.
Verse 10, it says, say ye to the righteous, and it should be well with them, and they should. Verse 11, whoa, stop. Verse 11, I tell you,
okay, you read that over again.
Okay.
Started with it, you know, it's a woman.
Oh,
right here. Yeah, how is standing up to plead, standing to judge the people? Yeah, how will enter to judge with the angels of people and oppressors thereof?
This is it right here, man. This is the judgment coming out. The word spoken of the judgment. So the Lord actually and asks the judgment, then it shall be understood that it was true, man.
For ye,
we're not the enforcers, we're just speakers.
For ye have eaten up the vineyards of the Lord that's in your house. What be ye that drink by people eating and grinding things of the Lord, saying, your house of the Lord?
And it's a shame talking to first towards our own people, man. Y'all people to be very close to their weapons. Let me tell you, their mind was a little happy when he said something like that. But see, it was a quick ass thing to set up on the ground. But yeah, no, you don't get that too. But I see why they're doing something like this.
Yeah.
Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem, Rakakadash. Above, above.